All right, guys, it is day 3.5, and we're heading on to Disneyland. You guys ready?
You get tacos.
Get tacos? I don't want to eat anymore. I'm done. No more eating.
You want to be in it?
Hi.
All right, so we're finally at Disneyland Parks, and first stop is going to Emporium and just checking out what kind of merch they have. And secondly, we're here to get my birthday pin as well as my first visit pin. And the wonderful cast member did an amazing job drawing my name as well as a balloon. Oh my God, there's so many cute plushies in this room, but I had to hold myself back and we had to move on.
Behind you, Mickey, right over here. There you go. We
didn't want to waste too much time, so we headed towards Tomorrowland to get to Space Mountain to ride our first attraction, and we saw Cinderella's castle. I'm so excited. So we're here in Tomorrowland and we're making our way towards Space Mountain, and the line was relatively short. We kind of buzzed right through, and I just miss Space Mountain so much. It's been so many years since I've last ridden this ride. After getting off Space Mountain ride, we ran into our first 100th year anniversary Medallion machine, and I collected all 4 Star Wars coins. And then right next to it was also a pressed penny machine, and Alan still wanted to collect the pennies, so we went ahead and pressed some pennies. He collected all 8 of them. We made our way towards the Star Trader in search of merch, as well as me trying to find the first visit pin, as the other 2 locations I visited didn't have any more pins. After asking about 2 other stores, we finally found our first visit pin. Not in a delay, we made our way towards Astro Blasters, and it's my first time for this attraction, and I heard so many people talk about beating their friends' scores and stuff like that, so I'm excited to play it for the first time.
The power cell, while the rest of you concentrate on those robots. You'll rendezvous at planet C. Battle stations, report to the flight deck for immediate launch to infinity and beyond.
Not gonna lie, this is a really fun ride. Although it was really hard to record and shoot, and also you had steering controls of turning the cart 360, that was really fun though. This attraction was immaculate. I love the neon designs, the set. Everything looks so nice, and as you can see, shooting was really interactive. It was really hard to shoot to squares with one hand while recording with the other hand, but I really enjoyed playing this game a lot, and I hope to play it again when I come back next time.
Yeah,
So I ended with 29,500 points, which is an L3 for Space Pilot. I'm curious what you guys got when you guys played. Let me know in the comments below.
You have saved our lives. We are eternally grateful.
Oh, we found ourselves at Little Green Man store command, and does anyone else have a problem with wanting to buy everything at Disneyland? After the Astro Blaster attraction, I ran into the Milk and Cookies Pretzel stand, and I heard so much about it from other Disney vloggers, so I had to pick one up. Alright, what's up everybody? So we're in Tomorrowland right now. We're stopping by Galactic Grill, and I saw the pretzel that I absolutely wanted to try as soon as I got to Disneyland, and I've been watching people talk about the Milk and Cookie Pretzel, so here it is. So what it is a pretzel filled with cream cheese. There and then on top has a taro glaze and then a bunch of cookies and cream crumbles on there. Alright, so as you can see inside is a little bit of cream, sour cream, but cream cheese. Inside is cream cheese. Let's go ahead and get a taste test. It's so good. Oh my god. The taro, you can taste the taro in there. It's lightly sweet, and I love the texture of the cookies and cream portion of it. Really good. Highly recommend it. We're checking out the Platinum Trifle, which has the chocolate on top, has a creme fraiche chantilly, and a cherry compote with a cookie crumble at the bottom, and a cookie mousse right here. Let's go ahead and try that out. And then on top, you see these little purple pellets. It's like a little something crispy. You get a really strong hint of that cherry compote. That's really good. I don't think I got any of the cookie crumble though. Try it one more time. There you go, I got some at the bottom. All right, guys. Minnie looking real stylish in her iridescent statue. As I was making my way towards Fantasyland, cutting through Cinderella's castle, I ran into the first band of the day. Such a surreal and magical experience walking through Cinderella's castle's bridge and being able to be in person and seeing the 100th year anniversary medallion with the fairy godmothers hoisted up there was amazing. And as you can see here, we're heading towards Fantasyland to get to Galaxy's Edge. Nothing was more magical than traversing Cinderella Castle's bridge with my traveling companion Mickey and Minnie New Emos. I'm so happy that we were able to cross this bridge together. Before we left, there were some Disney photographers and I asked them to take some pictures for me, and I linked it towards my magic band and I was able to download the pictures off my app. Before heading over to Galaxy's Edge, we tucked into Red Rose Tavern to get some early brunch, and I heard a lot about this little garden harvest from a YouTuber named Lisa Land, and I wanted to check it out myself.
Bonjour breakfast with the Mickey Mouse pancake and sausage.
What's up guys, so now we moved on to Fantasyland. We're over here at the Rose Tavern and we're getting some breakfast. So I got the Little Town Harvest right here, which is a vegan option. I heard a lot of really good things about it, especially about that sauce on there. And it just has quinoa and then tater tots and it looks like some kind of greens. I'm not familiar with greens. And yeah, I'm gonna try that out. And then over here for the savory side, we got the Bonjour breakfast. Look at that cute little croissant, guys. Like, look at this. Check that out. And then these bacon strips are actually really big, but they're thin and crispy. And it's got, you know, scrambled eggs and tater tots as well. All right. And then can't forget about the coffee. Look at this packaging. Like, they outdid themselves with the 100 year anniversary. I love that purple silver theme that they have going. So yeah, just gonna mix it up. that sauce in there. Just get a little bit of everything. You guys can see that. Mmm. That sauce is really good. It's like, almost like a chipotle sauce. And we finally made our way towards Galaxy's Edge. And if you guys know anything about me, I'm a huge Star Wars geek. And I love Star Wars. And it's so surreal to be here for the first time in person since it's opened. I haven't been to Disneyland since Galaxy's Edge opened up. And I've been dying to come here. And just walking past that front gate, I was already in for a treat. And once I got past and I saw the backdrop, I knew how much work went into this, and it felt so immersive. I felt like I was actually at a Star Wars universe.
You may be stopped and questioned at any time. I think this group needs to work on looking not suspicious.
Thank you. Your allegiance is noted.
Excessive data pad transmission will be monitored.
Citizens, continue enjoying yourselves.
Recon warned us about you. Don't cause any trouble.
I'm keeping my eye on you.
Good day.
Blue milk. What's up, guys? We're in Galaxy's Edge checking out Bubba Wampa Family Farms, and we're gonna try out their blue milk. Let's try it out. Ooh, it's like a blue raspberry flavor. The consistency is really good. It's like almost like a milk, in between a milkshake and like an icy. Mmm. Check it out. With my blue milk in one hand and my curiosity fed about what the blue milk tasted like, it was finally time to continue our adventure through Galaxy's Edge. And I was just really, really enjoying the moment, taking in the views. And here we are coming up to Millennium Falcon's Smuggler's Run attraction right here. And this is where the Millennium Falcon is held. And my God, I was just so amazed by how big it was. Three. Hi. Thank you. There were so many stores. We finally ducked into this shop. It was called Savvy's Workshop. And this is where they hand build lightsabers. And I was just going through looking at many different merches they had. Next up on the tour, Galaxy's Edge takes us to the marketplace, and it really is like a marketplace. It was bustling, and every side, left and right, had stores along all the way down the corridor, and it was a lot to take in. I didn't even personally step into any of these stores just because we didn't want to get tied down by checking out the awesome merch that they had, so we just kept it moving and just really trying to take in the visuals and really explore for the first time for me. So we finally made it to Rise of Resistance, the most popular ride at Galaxy's Edge, and it was a 2.5 hour wait, and we finally made it inside, and we were getting really close to the front.
BB-8, prep the ready room for recruits. Commander 9-9, please report back to IGS cockpit.
Is everyone assembled? Good. Should you be in flight prep? Recruits, thank you for joining the cause. A covert resistance team led by my friend Finn has infiltrated a First Order Star Destroyer that is now headed to this system. Your outpost on Batuu is no longer safe. We have transports waiting to take you to General Organa's secret base on Pokhara. I'll regroup with you there. The Resistance desperately needs your help in our fight against Kylo Ren and the First Order. Remember, it is vital that you keep the location of the Pokhara base secret. Lieutenant Beck, one of our top commanders, will lead you.
Affirmative. Transport is ready. Nine-Nom and I shall personally see them delivered.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Welcome to the cause. May the Force be with us.
Commander Poe Dameron and a squadron of X-Wings shall escort us to the rendezvous point on Bacara.
Roger, this is Black Leader. I hear you're a fine-looking group of recruits. Well, no time to waste. Let's get you on your way to the General.
Stand clear. Deck doors opening now.
I just want to be sure.
All recruits must be on board now. Transport is away in 30 seconds.
Good.
Look at another hyperdrive.
Yes, check the hyperdrive also. There appears to be a number of small craft heading our way. Raise the shields.
We got company. First order TIE fighters. Reroute.
With getting you to Bacara.
Red 2, Blue 5, keep tight now. Let's get ready to make that jump to light speed on my mark.
Black Leader, we're picking up an unusual signal. Are you spotting anything?
Yeah, I see it. We'll check it out. BB-8, what do you got?
There appear to be a number of small craft heading our way. Raise the shields.
We got company! First order TIE fighters!
Copy that. Get us clear so we can make the jump.
Be ready. You won't have much time.
Where are all those TIE fighters coming from?
Get out there. One ended.
Star Destroyers.
Get out of there!
We can't. We're caught in a tractor beam. It's pulling us in.
Hey, it's a prize to make this a fair fight. Don't worry. I'm coming back for you. Stay strong.
Is there anything we can do, Nine-Nine?
Get away, Doka.
No, the tractor beam will be too strong.
Can any of you do that?
Cargo vessel TR-141, identify yourselves and prepare to be boarded.
This is TR-141. We are a civilian vessel. By whose authority are we being detained?
By the authority of the First Order, Resistance Scum. Now bring down your shields and prepare to be boarded.
Now, Twig, get out there!
They'll want a location of our secret base. Tell them nothing. The future of the Resistance is at stake. I have a bad feeling about this. Stand back from those doors!
Attention Resistance allies! This vessel is now under First Order command. All of you guys get out.
Thank you.
Okay, that guy's head moved.
Securely fastened. Keep hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the transport and supervise your children. What? Tell them it's a prisoner transfer. Did it work? Good. Now get a move on. There's a clear path to the turbo lifts at the end of the hallway. Turn right.
They got trapped.
Probe droid. You're lucky it didn't spot you. Take those turbo lifts and stay out of trouble.
Hey, you're not authorized. Wait, those are the prisoners.
Your cover is blown. Find an alternate route. Who picked these two droids anyway? Does not look good. Try to find another way down to the escape pods.
The Resistance will attempt to rescue the prisoners.
They have neither the resources nor the courage to engage us.
You underestimate their conviction. Raise the shields!
Shields? I see no evidence.
Now!
Found the alarm! All personnel to their stations!
Sir, the prisoners have escaped.
How brave. Rebels. There's nowhere to run.
Came in a little off target. Ground crews will meet you outside the wreck. All right, nice job, recruits. Not what you signed on for, but hey, you're resistance now. I think I have that authority. Right, Beck? Where's the lieutenant? I need eyes on Beck. Line up, scan for his pod beacon.
Lieutenant Beck here.
Beck, you're alive.
I should hope so. Great job, recruits. Thanks to your heroism, the location of the Resistance base is secure. Bravo! Yes, R5, you too.
Okay, this is one of the funniest and most random thing I found in the middle of Galaxy's Edge is this guy playing on a xylophone.
I'm being on stage by a fork. Come on, John, sing with us.
I'm not a good singer, so.
Yeah,
never mind.
Ronto Wrap!
Yeah. We were still hungry, so we stopped by Ronto Roasters to get another lunch. Alright, what's up, guys? So we're here in Galaxy's Edge at Ronto Roasters, and unfortunately, we missed the breakfast one, but I did get a Ronto Wrap, which is a pork sausage. Pita wrap with some cabbage and vegetables and some kind of meat in there, probably pork. So yeah, and then since we're here, I also got the Destron ice cap, which is a Sprite with orange syrup and a foam cheese. All right, let's check it out. Cheers. Alright, let me get the Dashon ice cap. That cheese foam is really good. It's rich, salty. It's got a nice orange flavor to it. I'll come with you.
We're done.
Just as I was wrapping up lunch, in front of me I noticed Fennec Shand and Boba Fett, so I had to run over to see if I can get a picture with them.
Can I work with you someday?
That was a success. I got a picture of Boba, but Fennec Shand ran away. Through Galaxy's Edge, we made our way to 100th Acres and Friends, and I saw that there was a line for Winnie the Pooh and Tigger, and I thought it was short, but it was actually very long, so I actually took a candid picture of Winnie the Pooh, and he actually waved, and that's how you cheat the system. Satisfied with my picture that I didn't have to wait in line for, I made my way over to Pooh's Corner, and it just made me remember my bestie Jasmine Tay and her love for Winnie the Pooh, and everything Winnie the Pooh in here made me want to buy something for her as a gift, but she made sure that I didn't buy her anything, so I had to be disciplined and buy it. After leaving the 100 Acres and Friends, we found ourselves at New Orleans Square, and we were going to the Royal Street Veranda for some of their beignets. And of course, I ran into Captain Jack Sparrow and got a picture. We finally made our way to Royal Street Veranda and we got the beignets. And just FYI, you guys have to order it on the mobile app as a pre-order. You guys cannot just go to the window and order it. I made that mistake and I had to wait an extra 20 minutes. So make sure you guys do that. And of course, I for some reason didn't get audio of my mukbang here. So anyways, it was pretty short. The beignets, we just shook it up in the bag to get a consistent sugar ratio to it. And I just love how the video filmed it for this part. And of course, I had my first beignet ever, I believe, and it was very pillowy. I wouldn't say it blew my mind, but it was actually really, really good. I think it was, if it was hot, it would have been a lot better. Over at the Jolly Holiday, we've got the lemon tea cake as well as the beef birria toasted cheese sandwich. After lunch, we made our way back to Galaxy's Edge because I was determined to find Fennec Shand, but I ran into the Mandalorian and Baby Yoda instead.
Hello. Say hello.
And then I also tried the green milk, but it was not as good as the blue milk. Just as I was about to give up and leave Galaxy's Edge, I finally found Fennec Shand as she was walking up the stairs, and I had to say hi and get a picture with her.
And it's her birthday?
Yes, it is.
How's it going?
Good.
Get all the
chocolates
needed.
I did. And I was over here earlier when you were Boba, but you disappeared from me.
You are. Yeah. Are you wearing this scarf?
Yes.
It's not too bad. As long as
you're not
protected.
She's from the
Middle East. Just for that challenge?
Yes. Yeah. Would you be able to take this with me? Great.
Right.
We had booked an appointment for our lightning lanes to go to Guardians of the Galaxy over at Disney California Adventure Park, so it's time to swap parks, and we were not planning on staying here long because we have to hop back to Disneyland Parks to attend the Magic Happens Parade, which started at 6:30 and it was about 4 o'clock about this time, so I was just trying to take in the sights and do as much as we can before we had to hop back and get a good seat because we had to get there at least 45 to 30 minutes early to get a good front row seat to see the parade.
I never thought I'd be the one to tell. It's so easy and so wonderful beneath your spell.
I saw everyone was crowding around Chef Goofy, so I decided to come over to see what was going on. I couldn't get a picture of him, but just wanted to get a little recording before I left. Aside from the First Order Stormtroopers, Groot's costume is actually jaw-dropping amazing. I just love the details on him. I mean, just look at him. That was so amazing. The last time I walked down these streets, it was the Tower of Terror, and now that I'm back, it is now Guardians of the Galaxy, and it was very interesting to see just how much it's changed. We're finally here, and there was a huge line in the standby line. I'm so glad that we had Genie Plus and booked a Lightning Lane appointment, and yeah, I just love the detailing here. Everything was amazing. Look at the pompous collector's painting, and I love his wall of celestial heads.
Make this world do everything you say.
friends. You're one step closer to your exciting encounter with the Guardians of the Galaxy.
That'll leave a mark.
You are now standing in my private office.
I know.
Where I carefully scrutinize
each and every piece that comes to me from different parts of the galaxy. And after that, bless you, this guy.
Hearing you insist that gathering on a constant loop was big motivation for me to escape. I go, ouch! Ow! What was that? Was not part of the plan. What? Of course I escaped. For those of you who have not been paying attention, the name's Rocket, one of the Guardians of the Galaxy. The smart one. Listen up. He's gonna put you on a gantry lift for your tour. I'm gonna sneak on top of your lift and take us all the way to the big old generator control room. I'm gonna blast that thing and destroy all the control systems, which will open up every cage in this freak show and free my friends. Our buddy Mantis is in the getaway ship waiting for my signal, and then we'll be on our merry way. But this plan won't work unless you help. I don't have clearance. My hands don't scan. Yours do. If you raise your hands, I get the clearance and the chaos begins. It's a foolproof plan.
Huh. I'm going to take this.
Now move it.
After that long immersive introduction, there was more lines. I thought this was finally getting to the ride, and at this point I was getting scared because I wasn't sure if we were going to make it to our parade, because one of the rides actually got broken and I think they had to transfer everyone to the other working one. But we finally got there and we made it.
Purely fast. Keep your hands, arms, feet and legs inside the gantry lift at all times. And please watch your Terran children. Thank you.
So it was time to get back to Disneyland Park, but before we got back, we went to Elias & Co., which is supposedly the biggest shop on this side of the park, just to get merch.
Yeah.
my god, watching the Magic Happens parade for the first time in my life, that was spectacular, and I am so glad that we came early to camp out and got a good spot, and we watched at nighttime instead of the daytime show. And now we're on our way to Tomorrowland to check out some merch because we had some free time. We booked a lightning lane to go to the Millennium Falcon's Smuggler's Run, and we had about 40 minutes to kill, so we went over here to look at some merch and before we head back to Galaxy's Edge again for the third time today. Walk through there. Yeah. And if you wait, she sings.
It's creepy.
Oh! Oh! Something happened. And I found another group of photographers at front of Cinderella's castle, so I had to get another picture. It's free, and I regret not doing more during the daytime. I'm so glad that I walked past Cinderella's castle at nighttime because, oh my god, was it even more pretty at nighttime than it was during the daytime. I was in love with the color changing effects that it had, and I love the glowing medallion, guys. So pretty. And we're back at Galaxy's Edge for the third time tonight, and this is the first time I'm back at nighttime, and oh my god, I just love seeing the people with the lightsabers walking around. They definitely stand out more at nighttime. You can see them glowing super bright, and I saw this girl, she was practicing with her dual wield lightsabers, and this is really cool. Like I said, I'm a big Star Wars geek, but not enough to purchase a lightsaber. One, they're very expensive, and two, they're very clunky, and I would never trust myself with that. But I'm really happy to see that other people were around just to show off their lightsaber skills.
Wait. I don't speak Wookiee.
Yeah.
They're saying she's hairy, dude.
Why are you here on
that too?
To an old outpost on a remote planet, practically in wild state. I don't buy it. Well, aren't you clever? Have eyes on you. That is affirmative.
We're finally over at Smuggler's Run, and we're getting ready to go to the attraction.
And welcome to my completely legitimate shipping company, Onaka Transport Solutions. I am sorry I could not be there to welcome you in person, but the work of a smuggler and a businessman is never done. I have many, many ships, and I have far too much cargo. What I need are pilots to transport it, gunners to protect it, and engineers to make sure it gets there in one piece. And that is where you come in, as my new flight crews, traveling on the fastest ships in the quadrant. Like that one, the Millennium Falcon. Oh, Chewbacca! Of course you will be compensated for the generous loan of your ship, and the Resistance will get the supplies they need, and maybe a little something for you. It is time to go, my friends. Disengage from your mission and try to work together now. Your lives and profits depend on it. So let's get to another ship. Intercepting a first order trading shipment of coaxia. Gunners, you clear the path. Pilots, line up behind the train. And engineers, you harpoon that precious cargo. Now, despite what you may have heard, my friends, when you work for Onaka Transport Solutions, there is no need to worry. Everything is precise, professional, and... What do you mean, system failure?
Oh, that's what you mean by system failure.
Of course I repaired the power couplers. I mean, not personally, but I had someone repair the... I think I had someone repair the power couplers. Never mind that. R5, access the emergency power supply.
of life. What good is an emergency power supply if it's not ready in an emergency? This is unacceptable. I have a ship ready, a crew waiting, and nobody is making me any money. Does anyone have a lantern, a lightsaber, a little stab? This is ridiculous.
Follow the crew member and we'll get this fixed right away, my friends. Go, go, go.
For your safety, remain safe.
Right, pilot, push the flashing button to take off. Pilot on the left, move your stick to fly right and left. I was just about to say that. Pilot on the right, pull back on the stick to fly up and push forward to fly down. Oh, weapons are offline. Left pilot, hit the booster. Now let's go get that coaxial. Right pilot, hit the jump to right speed.
Time to watch Wondrous Journeys, the new show that was added, and we camped out here for an hour before the show and we got pretty much front row seats, so very excited to see this show for the first time.
Tonight, as we take you on these wondrous journeys beginning tonight at 9:30, just a few reminders before we get the party started. During the show, all of the viewing areas between the castle and the Main Street train station are all standing room only. Standing room only. You don't have to stand up just yet, but please be ready. Earlier today, we brought the return of a Walt's favorite train engine. Engine number 2, nickname 1. We finally have Magic Happens back after a long time. We had a couple of the performances earlier today.
Yes.
In the finale of Magic Happens, there are 3 floats before the Sleeping Beauty float. I will give you an honorary citizen button if you can list them in order that they appear in the parade.
Is it,
dun, 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 dun.
No, Princess and the Frog, Coco, and then Frozen?
It is not.
It's a 3.
It's a 3, so it's a unit that leads right up Sleeping Beauty.
It's Cinderella, Sword in the Stone, and Princess and the Frog.
Yes.
Ooh. Wow.
Yes. That is correct. The finale 3.
Good job.
Watch again.
From dream to the stupid. Oh.
That just about wraps up my time at Disneyland. I wish I had a lot more time to do more. If I had 2 days at the park, it would have been a lot more beneficial. But I hope you guys enjoyed joining me on this journey together with me at Disneyland for the first time in a long time on my birthday. And I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. And if you guys stick through the whole way, I appreciate you guys so much. I'll see you guys in the next vlog.